Hello student, in my previous class of class 10 I have discussed few things. What are those? Electricity, current, Joule law of heating, and how resistance depends on the length of the conductor, the radius or cross sectional area of the conductor, the temperature. We also know the difference between conductor, insulator, semiconductor. We know who are called the ohmic conductor. Today my discussion is completely on a completely practical things which is very well known to us, that is household circuit. Today my topic of discussion is, that is chapter 9 from that your concepts physics book, that is household circuit. First of all, when I am telling you household circuit, before that we should know how we are getting electrical energy or power, means actually from the power station, means it may be a hydroelectric city power, it may be from wind energy, it may be from tidal power, it may be from thermal electric plant. So from there we are getting kilovolt range energy. Clear? Means from power station we are getting, in short form I am writing it PS. So from power station we are getting, how actually in our home, what we are using actually in our home, we are generally use 220 volt or 240 volt of energy, means domestic appliances. What our domestic need, we need 220 volt or 240 volt, or in some country it is 230 volt. Means power station generate the electrical energy in kilovolt range. Clear? Power station generally produce electricity in kilovolt range. After many part, means from power station it's gone to somewhere, from it's gone to somewhere, and then after so many things, after so many steps, we are getting that 240 volt or 220 volt of electrical energy or electrical voltage or EMF. Clear? So how we are getting, what are the steps? First of all, in power station it is seen that, see what PDF I had included with this that class, there the diagram given. Okay, so you go through that diagram. Here I am just giving you a schematic structure. So in power station, what is there? We are having generally either 11 kilovolt, or in a multiple of 1.11 kilovolt of energy, means it may be 22 kilovolt, it may be 33 kilovolt. So in power station generally this type of electrical energy produced by either thermal, from coal, burning coal, they are producing electricity, or hydroelectric power or other thing. So we are getting normally this range of electrical energy. Now see, our home appliances are very sophisticated, so we don't need this huge energy. But there are some industry, they need more than 33 kilovolt or more than 11 kilovolt energy. So after power station, the electrical energy next goes to grid substation. Remember, so after power station, the electrical energy goes to grid substation. So this is number one. Here the generation first. This is the home of electricity. Here electricity generated, electrical power generated. So after that, it's going through grid substation. Now why it is going through grid substation? See, grid substation is a place where we are doing step up of the electrical energy. Now what is step up or step down? See, suppose I am having, I am just giving you a example. Suppose I am having 10 kilovolt of electrical energy, AC current. I need 100 kilovolt. Clear? So by which instrument from 10 kilovolt to 100 kilovolt I will get? That instrument is called transformer. What is the symbol of transformer? You know, everyone had seen, those who have done the motor part in project, motor, they are utilizing motor. In motor, transformer is there. What is the purpose of transformer? Transformer always stepping up or stepping down the alternating current. Means transformer always stepping up the current or stepping down the current or voltage. Now see, so in grid power station, we are having a step up transformer. In grid substation, we are having various grid. Grid means the coil, the structure. This is called grid. So since too many grids are there present, so this is a transformer. So in grid substation, transformer, they are all are step up transformer. In grid substation, step up transformer convert this 11 kilovolt or 20 kilovolt or 30 kilovolt, whatever may be the source, to nearly 132 kilovolt. Clear? So this is the second phase. This is the first phase. This is second phase. So I am having right now 132 kilovolt in grid substation. Let's see. Now, from grid substation, still our requirement, home requirement is to nearly 220 volt. It is 132 kilovolt. Now, then we are having main, the current is going to main substation from grid. Second was on grid. From grid substation, it is coming to main substation. Clear? Main substation. What is the purpose of main substation? Main substation, there we are having step down transformer. It is step up. Now, main substation is step down transformer. In main substation, we are converting 132 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. Clear? Main substation, stepping down the current from current or electrical energy from 132 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. Now, in our state or in our country, there are various requirements. Means there are some heavy industry, there are some light industry, means some need huge power, some need less power. So those who are needing 33 kilovolt range of energy, those industry need 33 kilovolt energy from main substation directly. The current 33 kilovolt going to industry, heavy industry, remember, heavy industry needs nearly 33 kilovolt. So from main substation, after stepping down, it is going to heavy industry. Clear? Now still my requirement, my home requirement is nearly 220 volt. Still I am not getting 220 volt. So 33 kilovolt of range of energy, some part of that connection is going to heavy industry. Clear? Now, rest of the 33 kilovolt from main substation, it is coming to intermediate substation. This is the third part. Main substation is the third part. So, main substation, it is coming to intermediate substation. Main substation, it is coming to intermediate substation. What is the purpose of intermediate substation? Again, intermediate substation, they are having step down, series of step down transformer. They are converting 33 kilovolt of energy to nearly 11 kilovolt of energy. Clear? They are needing, they are converting 33 kilovolt of energy to 11 kilovolt energy. Now, there are some light industry who need nearly 33 kilovolt. They are getting their power from this intermediate substation. Clear? They are not getting from main substation. They are getting intermediate substation. Here also, we are stepping down the current or electrical energy. Now, from intermediate substation, it is coming to our well-known CEST substation, or I can say CT substation. So, okay, now the current or electrical energy coming to here, current or electrical energy is coming to intermediate substation. As I am telling, intermediate substation. What is the purpose of intermediate substation? As I said, in intermediate substation,
there is a step down process going on, that is 33 kilovolt to it is 11 kilovolt, 33 kilovolt to 11 kilovolt. Now after intermediate, those light industry need 11 kilovolt of energy, they are getting this much from intermediate substation. Now after intermediate substation, electrical energy coming to CSC or city substation. Clear? Say the full form of city substation is not CSC. I am just giving you an example. That is from intermediate substation, it is coming to our well-known city substation. The grid we can see in CSC office, Taratala or somewhere else. All are the city substation. In city substation, we are getting the we are doing the last part of step downing process. Means from 11 kilovolt to 220 volt. Clear? So from 11 kilovolt to 220 volt. And from city substation, we are getting the electrical energy in home appliances. Now there are three things. What are that? You can ask me, ma'am, we need 11 kilovolt. So, and that power station also at the first half of the generation, it is always generating 11 kilovolt or 33 kilovolt. So whatever is our purpose, whatever is our need, why we are not taking from there? There are few drawbacks. I am discussing one after another. What are the drawbacks? First of all, in previous class, I had discussed Joule law of heating. What is Joule law of heating? That is heat energy equal to I square RT. Clear? Heat energy is equal to I square RT. Another thing is what? That is P equal to VI, means electric power is equal to volt into current. So from there, what I am getting? I equal to P by V. So, if in the denominator part we are having 11 kilovolt or 33 kilovolt of energy, so current will be what? Current will be less. Less current means less is the generation of heat. Another thing, we know R equal to rho L by A. Now, from power station directly through a long conducting wire in our home, the electrical energy is coming, means LT is increasing, length, L, if L is increasing, resistance offered by the wire will be increased. If resistance offered by the wire is increased, heat generated by the wire is increased, means there is a risk factor. Clear? Another thing, whenever you are doing stepping up or stepping down, it is the step after step process. Means directly it is not possible for a single grid or a multiple of grid, directly you are doing from 11 kilovolt to 130, 130 to 220, not possible. So we have to do what? From 130 to something, suppose 40, so 40 to 11, 11 to that 220. So that's why this whole process is going on. As another drawback is that normally in a state or country there are 20, or in a state there are 2 or 3 power stations possible. Like our, we are having DVC, Damodar Valley Corporation, and we are having that Kolaghat Thermal Power. So it is far away from city, and normally electrical energy, except industry, most of the uses are now present is also in city. It makes maximum persons stay in city, so maximum utilization of electrical energy always in city. So if from Kolaghat Thermal Power or Durgapur, through the long electrical wire is coming, means huge heat is generated, not possible, it's not very effective, means each wire need a heat sink. Needs a cooling source, means so many the monetary problem will arise there. So there is a sub stepping down or stepping up continuously, step by step process. Okay, in my next class or next video I will continue to the household circuit. Thank you.